In this presentation, we're going to look how we can put an internal 90 degree bend in steel cable tray. We know from talking in the classroom that we can use a cable tray bending machine, and we know also that we can buy them from the manufacturers and just bolt them into place. So first of all, we're going to look at how simple it is to put a 90 degree bend in using the cable tray bender. And then we're going to look at how we can overcome it if, for instance, we're on a building site late in the day, we haven't bought an internal 90 degree bend and the cable tray bending machine isn't available. Can we manufacture one ourselves? So this presentation is all about trying to manufacture an internal 90 degree bend in cable tray. In order to use this cable tray bending machine, we must use the straight flange variety of cable tray. We cannot use the return flange style because it doesn't fit into the slots in the machine and allow you to pull an internal or external bend on it. So it has to be the straight flange variety of cable tray in order to use the machine. Let's set it up and see that bend. So our cable tray bending machine has two supports for the cable tray itself. These slide backwards and forwards depending on the width of the cable tray, and the actual flanges sit into a groove within the actual side supports. We slide it in like so. There is also a bar at the top here to stop the cable tray from flicking up. So if I remove the pin on the side here, you can see that obviously it needs to be prevented from moving away. And with a conduit bending machine as well, exactly the same, we have an arm in order to pull down for the bend itself. So we lift up the arm, we insert the cable tray in so, we make sure the pin is in place to prevent the bar from moving up, and we pull ourselves our 90 degree bend. It is difficult for me because I can't step away, so I'm going to see an approximate 90 degree internal bend. So as I pull down, what will happen, however, as you go to pull it out, you tend to pull out slightly the 90 degree bend or the bend that you require. So you must be careful of that as you pull the tray free from its position. Like so. And you can see I've got approximately a 90 degree bend. It may be that I have to put it back in just to work it, or I can just maybe flex it into position. So I've created myself a 90 degree internal bend using cable tray bending machine. However, in this video, I want to show us if we've forgotten to perhaps buy a manufactured 90 degree internal bend, or there is no access to a cable tray bending machine on site, can I produce quite simply an internal 90 degree bend? Let's have a look at that in the next part of the presentation. So we saw in the first part of the presentation how we can put an internal 90 degree bend in straight flange cable tray using a cable tray bending machine. We also said in the first part of the presentation that you can buy internal 90 degree bends from electrical wholesalers, which can be bolted into place. However, we're going to now look at a technique where we have neither options. We haven't got a cable tray bending machine, and we haven't bought from the wholesalers an internal 90 degree bend. So can we produce and make one? We're going to use a bar. This is just a piece of metal I've got from my engineering workshop. So a piece of bar, it could be a large screwdriver, and there is a slot in one end. So all I've done is used a hacksaw and put a groove slot in one end. We're going to use this in order to make an internal 90 degree bend in our straight flange cable tray. So let's see that in the next part of the presentation. So I'm going to take my homemade bar. So I've got a piece of metal with a slot cut in it. I said it could be a large screwdriver you no longer needed, and you've put a groove in one end of the shaft of the actual screwdriver itself. So either way, I've got a groove in a piece of metal to use as a lever in order to put the crimp section similar to this here of the internal 90 degree bend in the cable tray. The advantage of doing it yourself is that you can make the bend considerably slower. So in other words, you could have a more gradual bend than the one formed by the tray bending machine, or we could make quite a severe or tight bend. It does depend on the bending radius of the cables that are going to be laid on the tray. So see how we're going to do it then. So taking our bar, I've got a point here at the top. It doesn't matter where I start. I'm going to do it somewhere in this section here. So I've got no marks on the tray at the moment. I'm just going to improvise this internal 90 degree bend. Position like so. So I've got my slotted section of my bar down onto the actual flange itself, and I'm just going to pull it inwards first. So I went in, and already you can see that my tray's just fractionally kicked up and I've got a kink in the side of the flange. So I went in first, I go to the end of the kink section and I bring it out the opposite way. So I'm going to pull it towards myself, kink again, and repeat the process once more. Go to the end of the part that's kinked and kink once again. So we've now got several kinks in position on the actual flange itself. starting going in first, out, and then back in again. We'll do one more. So we go to the end of the kink section and we pull now back in. So I've done about three, in, out. Turn it round now and repeat the process parallel with where you started the last one, remembering I went in first. Lining it approximately up and we went in first, back out, and then back in. Looking from the side on, you can already see my tray has started to raise up. We've gone in, out, as we've got a kink section, similar to the kinking that was produced by the cable tray bending machine itself. It's going to take me a few moments now to work this down in order to bring it up to 90 degrees. So let's see that in the next part of the presentation. So using just a bar with a groove that I'd cut in with a hacksaw and that crimping technique, I've managed to produce an internal 90 degree bend in cable tray without the need for a cable tray bending machine or to buy one from the manufacturer. Friday afternoon on a construction site, need an internal bend, no cable tray bending machine, no wholesaler's going to deliver you one in time. Can you produce one simply? Bar with a groove in it. Simple in and out technique on each side can produce me a 90 degree internal bend, very similar to the one that was produced using the cable tray bending machine, but I have control over how slow this internal bend is. So if I put less force on my motions in and out, I make a more gradual bend. If I needed to increase the bending radius, I can put more force on the in and out crimps in order to make a tighter internal bending radius. So, simple technique in order to put an internal bend in, only using a simply modified piece of metal bar. I hope this video has been some help.